Good morning. Welcome to Worship in the Grove. Whether you're here in person or watching the live stream or joining us another time during the week, we give God thanks for you and for your love for God and neighbor. When you arrive at worship, we hope that you'll continue to go to the welcome table areas to receive your bulletin and to share your offering. Next Sunday, we'll be celebrating Christmas in July with Christmas carols, and for this month, we've been collecting socks and underwear for area shelters. Please drop your items off, your donations, on the at the porch during the week, or bring them with you to church on Sundays. On Sunday, there will be Christmas cookies by our bakers, and we'll also have a bagged lunch for who's ever here to either enjoy here or to take home with you. And there's also a canvas painting party that Miss Tiffany is leading. And we just ask, you don't have to sign up for the lunch, but if you could sign up for the canvas painting so that she can plan, that would be great. Anybody can do the painting, kids, or all of us. In-person worship will also happen in the sanctuary on August 1st, which is a communion Sunday, and August 22nd. And then we hope to start having both services, 8 and 10:30, in the sanctuary starting September 12th. Today we welcome and thank cast members from Godspell who are sharing some of their music with us today. And I invite director William Marshall forward to share more about that.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hello, hello, hello. Test 1, 2, 3. Test 1, 2, 3.
Hey, green.
1, 2, 3, green. I have a red light.
Yeah, that's not good.
Should I use another one?
Good morning. It's going well. Hello. I'm getting really comfortable up here on the Grove, having been here last Sunday, Friday, Saturday night, now this morning, and a couple more times coming up here in the future. So as Pastor Chris had mentioned, we're really excited for our Christmas in July, which we're doing next Sunday. But then 2 weeks after that, we will be performing our Godspell in concert, which we are very excited about, July 30 and 31 here on the outside Grove. 10 singers, a live orchestra, it's a 6-piece band, I believe, and it's going to rock out. So whatever you're thinking, double it. It's really, really going to be very exciting, and I hope after you hear some of this music this morning, you'll really, really be interested in joining us. If you are interested in joining us, we do have tickets available this morning over on this side gazebo, smaller gazebo. After the service, we'll be selling a few cash tickets, or you can access purchasing tickets online at Eventbrite, or through our Facebook page, an event for that Godspell in concert. So I will turn it back over, but thank you, and we hope you enjoy the music this morning.
We had two beautiful nights of music this weekend with the Broadway music. William, Ronnie, Abby, and Kim just shared two bunch of gorgeous music, so thank you for that. Join me in our greeting. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. Please stand. Be sure to wave and smile at your neighbors. Our favorite hymn today is, You Have Come Down to the Lake Shore. Raise your hand if it's one of your favorites. Yeah, Madeline Bingle and Eric Minnick gave us that one.
Thank you.
Let's join in all together with each other. Let us build a community of worship. God be with us as we worship together. As we gather for worship today, we look around and pay attention to where we are, and we smile, smiling at those who worship with us, or as we think of friends who are gathering in other places, or as we think of those we're missing or who can't be with us. We recall that you, our God, are with us when we worship in ones and twos, in groups and crowds, in our homes, inside church buildings, and outside in your creation. We pause in our weekly doings to gather together and with you. Be with us, we pray. Amen. Please be seated.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I would like to invite any children that are here, and parents too, if they would like to come over, to join me for a story. And it's called When God Made You and a Craft. So.
I invite the Beers family, Dale, if you could bring your family forward, please, so that we can share in baptism. Today we baptize Dale David Beers, son of Cassandra and Jarrett, and Tyler, Sean, Shana, and Alexis are coming forward as well. Baptism with water and the Holy Spirit is the mark of a child's acceptance into the care of Christ's church, the sign and seal of their participation in God's forgiveness, and the beginning of their growth in full Christian faith and discipleship. When we baptize children here, we are asking their parents and families and sponsors to make promises to God and to their child and to the church for their baby. And so we ask you these questions. Do you desire to have your child baptized into the family and faith of Jesus Christ? If so, please say, we do. Will you encourage your child to renounce the powers of evil, to receive and the freedom of new life in Christ? If so, say, we will with the help of God. Will you teach your child that they may be led to profess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior? If so, say, we will with the help of God. Do you promise, by the grace of God, to be Christ's disciple, to follow in the way of our Savior, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to witness to the work and word of Jesus Christ as best you are able? If so, say, we will with the help of God. And do you promise, according to the grace given you, to grow with your child in the Christian faith, to help them to be a faithful member of the Church of Jesus Christ by celebrating Christ's presence, by furthering Christ's mission in all the world, and by offering the nurture of the Christian church so that they may affirm their baptism? If so, say, we will with the help of God. We also ask the church to make promises to our children and families, church members and friends. Jesus calls us to make disciples of all nations, to offer them the gift of grace and baptism. Do you, who witness and share in this sacrament, promise your love, support, and care to these children and families? If so, please respond. We promise our love, support, and care.
We promise our love, support, and care.
The water that we use is not really anything special. It's just tap water. But what makes it special and holy is all of the promises that we're making together today to God and God's blessing of this water to remind us of these promises. And so we pray over the water, Blessed by your Holy Spirit, gracious God, this water, create new life in the one to be baptized today, that they may know your love and grace for them in Jesus Christ. Amen. And so we ask you to name your child fully in front of the congregation.
Dale David Beers.
Dale David Beers. Hello, Dale David Beers. Your cute little slinkies. Hello. You want to say hello to everybody? You're on TV, too. So I baptize you, Dale David Beers, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You are a child of God, disciple of Christ, and member of the church. Oh, sorry about that. Let us pray. Holy and loving God, mother and father to us all, embrace each of us as children in your household of love. Grant each of us the strength and wisdom to keep the promises that we have made to each other and to you today. Bless the parents and the families and the sponsors of these children. May they always know this place as their home. Bless Dale. Give him and all of us strength for life's journey, courage in time of suffering, the joy of faith, the freedom of love, and the hope of new life. Amen. And we're sharing with the family, thank you, a blanket that our knitters have, I'm going to just hand it to mom or dad, a blanket that our knitters have made and prayed over, and a Bible, and a certificate. And so if why don't you guys kind of stand in the middle so everybody can see you a little bit better. Come on over, all of you, and let's show them our love. You know what? I'm going to take your picture while you're here, too. Just the three of you. Sure, go ahead, go in. One, two, three. Thank you. You can take your seat, sorry. After the message, right? So, Susan, could you come up and read the scripture? Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, when you actually. Yeah, it looks like the bulletin. Looks like we messed up the bulletin. So, let's have you after the service. Sermon. Okay. All right. Can the person singing Learn Your Lessons Well sing your song now? And then we'll do the reading. Sorry, Susan. Sorry about that. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
I can see a swath of sinners sitting yonder, and they're acting like a pack of fools. Their minds wander instead of studying the good Lord's rules. You better pay attention, build your comprehension. There's gonna be a quiz at your ascension, not to mention any threat of hell. But if you're smart, Every bright description of the promised land, that you can reach it if you keep alert. Learning every line and every last command, that may not help you, but it couldn't hurt. First you gotta read them, then you gotta heed them. You never know when you're gonna need them. Just as old Elijah said to Jezebel, you better start to learn your lessons well. Comprehension. You never know when you're gonna mention.
Based on Ephesians 2:11-22. Read it again, please, Papa. Rebecca put on her best pouty face and looked up at her father. He chuckled warmly. All right, but we only have time for to read a little. What part do you want to hear? He asked. The part where it says Jesus makes us all bricks, Rebecca said. Her father looked at her puzzled. You know, the part about us all being family now. This was Rebecca's favorite part of the letter, because some of the other children of the church had been teasing her because she and her father were not Jewish. They were known as Gentiles, and she didn't know many of the old stories that the other children knew. She tried to explain that she and her family had different stories and traditions, but just last week, the children had teased her for not knowing the story of Isaiah. She and her little brother had spent many lonely hours playing on their own, feeling different. Her father rifled through the many pages of the letter to the churches. It had only been a week since the letter came to the church, but already it was making a difference in the way people behaved. They were more confident, excited about the future. But the best part, at least for Rebecca, is that they were all getting along better. Rebecca's father cleared his throat and began to read. Remember, you all come from different backgrounds, and before you came together in Christ, none of you were living in God's way. You were each lost without God and the hope that God brings to the world. But now you have all come together in Christ Jesus. You were all far away from God in your own ways, but Jesus has brought you all together and close to God. Now you are a big family. It doesn't matter if you are Jews or Gentiles, for when Jesus died, those differences no longer mattered. What matters now is the peace that God brings to us all. You are all now members of God's family, and Christians everywhere are now citizens of God's household. We are being built together like a house that has strong and firm foundations, built on the apostles and the prophets. And each person is like a brick, with Jesus Christ as the cornerstone that keeps all the other bricks from falling in on each other. Together we build the house. We are each important, and together we make a beautiful dwelling place for God. Rebecca smiled and put her hand in her pocket of her tunic. It was filled with clay marbles. Yesterday, each of the children that had teased her gave her their favorite marble as a way of saying sorry. And now she had enough to join them in the game. Thanks, Papa, Rebecca smiled. I'll be back at dinner. I'm going to go play with my friends.
So this summer, our theme has been Groove in the Grove, Music for the Soul, and we've been trying to incorporate a lot of different music and a lot of extra music events. And some of you have been giving me your favorite hymns, to see if we use it as a response or a hymn, if someone sings it, or I refer to it in a sermon. And I invite you to also continue to share those with me, as well as your favorite secular hymns. A secular hymn is a song that's not typically a sacred hymn or a church song, but it speaks to you, or it helps you sense God's presence, or maybe it inspires you in some way. So thanks to all of you who have given me your songs. Today's scripture lesson made me think of a song that I grew up with in the church in the 70s. I'm on. Oh, okay. All right, there we go. Good now? Not good? I'm going to keep talking and let's see how that goes. We're pretty loud now. So I was talking about the summer music theme. So keep getting me your songs. Today's scripture reminds me of a song that I grew up with in the 70s and 80s by Avery and Marcia. It was called, "I Am the Church, You Are the Church." And the chorus says, "I am the church, you are the church, we are the church together, all who follow Jesus all around the world, yes, we are the church together." And the verses focus on reminding us, I feel like I'm cutting out and it's not moving, so. The verses focus on reminding us that it's the people that are the church and not the building. The verse says, "The church is not a building, the church is not a steeple, the church is not a resting place, the church is a people. We're many kinds of people with many kinds of faces, all colors and all ages, from all times and places." We've always known that the church is not a building, but especially in this last year of COVID, that has taken on an even more powerful and special meaning. When we as the church and many churches and faith communities near and far, as people, not the buildings, did all that we could to continue God's mission and ministry here in NEFS, in our community and in our world. Truly, the church is not a building. The church is a people. I am the church and you are the church. Today in our lessons, as we begin to recover from a pandemic, we are challenged to continue to look at the church through a different lens, one of reconciliation and the breaking down of traditions that can divide and diminish us. I don't think it's just the mic where it is. It feels like the connection is disconnected. So the author of Ephesians celebrates that God's family is broadened and extended to include everyone, every cultural background. Gentiles are welcomed into the family as siblings in Christ, and scholars argue that Paul is probably not the author of this letter, and it was likely a general letter to all the churches in various communities. They suggest it might have been written like Paul, an apostle of Christ, to the saints who are in, and then the town or the village. And in the most ancient regions, he might have even just said, to all the saints. And so the early church and today's church are invited to keep in mind that God's reconciling and unconditional love for all was shown in Jesus. Christian communities throughout Asia Minor were finding their way. They consisted of people from different backgrounds, and the old animosities and traditions that existed between them were hard to move and shift. And we still struggle with that today in the church as well. It's often said that Sunday morning is the most divided and segregated hour of the week among Christians, as people go to their own communities, their own buildings, and sometimes focus only on what they have in common, so much so that what they have in common becomes what they worship instead of God. There seems to have been a hierarchy undermining the nature of the communities, with those from a Jewish tradition claiming superiority over the Gentiles by describing them uncircumcised. It's a way of saying that the Gentiles didn't quite measure up, didn't quite qualify to be included in God's covenant. And the epistle writer for today challenges that notion, saying that Gentiles don't need to become Jews, as indeed Jews do not need to become Gentiles. All are welcome in this new order created by Christ. The early church is called to build something new and unprecedented around the cornerstone of Christ. It's a paradoxical building with a strange architecture, built when walls and divisions are broken down and all humanities are reconciled into one. The language used implies that there is not something taken from the past, but rather it's in present time. It's something that's being done now and to be done in the future. Everything and all things will be challenged and changed by what is built. This week, scripture, it celebrates God's loving vision for healing and wholeness and unity and the compassion of God, who provides a home for the homeless, healing for the sick, and welcome to those who are considered outsiders. In my office at church, I have a sign that says Heaven on Earth, and it's a cornerstone to my theology and my ministry. I work for and pray for making God's love and grace real for everyone here and now, in this time and place, on earth, not just after we die in heaven. I grew up in the 70s when the musical Godspell was a brand new musical on Broadway. And every church and youth group that I was a part of knew the music and had their own variations of productions being made to tell this story of the mission and ministry of Jesus. In a way, it was a radical time in its time to have Godspell being played in your church, to have church music that didn't sound at all like church music. And in its time, Jesus Christ Superstar and Godspell were produced and created with this sort of hippie rock and roll feel to them, also radical in its time. To me, the music changed my life musically as well as spiritually. To be honest, each song in Godspell is my favorite, and when the show was revived and rearranged in 2011, it was only more gorgeous and moving to me than in the 70s and 80s. So when William came to me with his ideas for the summer, first to do a Broadway weekend and then to do a Godspell weekend, well, I said yes a million times yes. And so it's kind of been like Christmas for me this whole summer. The song you'll hear next brings us to this idea of church being the people, not the building, and continues this invitation and this challenge to hard work to build God's church, to build this beautiful city here and now in this time and place, not just a city of heaven and angels. So let's make this our prayer and our work. I am the church, you are the church, we are the church together. May we build this beautiful city.
Out of the smoke,
but we can build a city of men.
Let's pray. Oh God, hear our prayers. May we break down those things that separate us and others from your compassion and care. Oh God, hear our prayers. May we build up good relationships that support healing and wholeness and a unity that has space for everyone with all our similarities and differences. God, hear our prayers. May we accept the compassion and care of others as we grow together. Thank you, O God of love and grace, for calling us to be your church, your refuge, your holy ground to each other. Be with us as we recover from this pandemic as individuals and families, a community, the church, a country, a world. Give us courage and strength to live and be in ways that only increase your love and shalom here and in the world. Hear our prayers as we pray together as Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. CJ, you can come forward. Thanks. By offering our time and concerns and resources, we seek to participate in God's good work of care and compassion.
the good seed on the land, but it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. He sends the snow in winter, the warmth to swell the grain, the breezes and the sunshine, and soft, refreshing rain.
Look at the commission and blessing. As we leave worship today, we look around and pay attention to where we are. We smile, smiling at those who worshiped with us, or as we think of friends in other places, we recall that you, our God, are with us in ones and twos, in groups and crowds, in our homes, inside church buildings, and outside in your creation. As we go back to our weekly doings, be with us, we pray. Amen. We ask you to stand, and we thank Julie Ware and Susan Glosson for helping us lead. Put a little love in your heart from Madeline Bingle. Good tune. Thank you.